Thank you for tuning in on Taco Tuesday with me to talk about some new movies. And on my newest review, I'm going to be talking about Netflix's newest movie this week. I'm talking about Don't Look Up. And this is a star-studded cast. We have Leonardo DiCaprio, Jennifer Lawrence, Rob Morgan, Jonah Hill. There is a big hunk of star power in this movie. I can't even name them all right now. And if you would have asked me a few months ago, would I waste time watching a Netflix movie? Honestly, I would have said no, because I've not liked a whole lot of Netflix movies. I've liked a lot of Netflix series, but not their movies so much. However, in the last couple months, we've had some that I really like. So I was willing to give this movie a chance. And if you're a fan of Adam McKay's other films, which I have been, so I'm definitely curious about this one. This film talks about a world-ending comet headed straight for Earth. Sounds kind of familiar. Our scientists that discovered this comet is going to put an end game to our planet. And it just shows how frustrated they are dealing with the government, because the government doesn't really care about that right now. Showing the presidency more worried about winning the next election. What I really liked about this movie was how frustrating it could be to watch. However, at the same time, it manages to make you laugh with all the satire that's going on. Like I said, if you're familiar with the movie Vice and you thought that was a good movie, and movies like The Big Short, if you're into like these political satire movies, then I think you'll really appreciate this film. We get some really good performances out of everybody in this movie, and I found that very entertaining. You know, if you've seen one End of the World movie, you kind of seen them all. Between Armageddon, Deep Impact, Seeking a Friend for the End of the World, you kind of seen them all. However, this one felt different at the same time. In fact, I will add this movie to one of my favorite apocalyptic movies. Also, when I was looking at the cast, I was a little hesitant about Meryl Streep being in it, just because everyone else in the cast I've seen in other comedic films. However, I was like, you know what? I almost forgot Meryl Streep was in one of my favorite movies. She was in the film Death Becomes Her. So I was like, you know what? Never mind. She's got it. And Meryl Streep did an amazing job in this movie. I'm not into political movies at all. However, like in the last few years, I have liked a few. As long as you dumb it down for me and you explain it to me in a way I can understand, I will appreciate it. I just don't get too heavy into it. But like I said, movies like Vice and also The Big Short, I was really into. Just what made this film very engaging for me also is just because the fact when it's an end of the world movie, you do have to throw in some politics and also some social media in there as well. So I got some very familiar things from other favorite past end of the world films like Dawn of the Dead and other films like that. So I was really enjoying how they handled all that montage and the way all the chaos that it managed to capture. I'm going to give Don't Look Up a B+. Thanks for tuning in. Hope you like what you see here. I'm Mike the Movie Misfit. Please don't forget to hit like and subscribe, and I'll see you at the movies.